In today's Entertainment City, we are chatting with Lady Antebellum. The Grammy-winning trio is back with their first album in 3 years. And as they tell Terry Hart, this time off was just what they needed.
A lot of people are talking about the hiatus. We're putting it in quotes. But I kind of thought of this when I listened to the record as a bit of a reboot for you guys. Sure. Did it feel like that?
Absolutely. You know, I think we went nonstop for 9 years. And this was our chance to really kind of reboot. That's a great word because I think, you know, we've been recording and touring and promoting all of the above all at once together for so many years that we wanted to just be able to take a break, to live some life, and then come in and focus just solely on the creative.
So when we've lived some life, when we've had some babies, when we've had some marriages, how does that affect the creative process and what you guys want to express about life?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think, you know, a lot of people ask, you know, when your home life is happy, they're like, how do you write sad songs? It's like, you know, you pull from the past. So, you know, there's still a lot of songs about lost love. But, you know, for us too, you know, this is the first album that we've actually had a couple songs on there kind of about our kids.
You guys talk a lot about the genre that you work in. For those who don't know, what is that country family?
It's like a big family reunion everywhere you go. We were so honored to get to know a lot of these people really well over the years, Luke Bryan and Miranda Lambert and Little Big Town and all these artists that we really consider friends. When our song came out, You Look Good, I mean, Dierks Bentley group texted us all. Everyone is so genuine and nice and kind to each other and is rooting each other on.
Yeah, we inspire each other.
Now, hitting the road is second nature to Lady A at this point, and they're getting ready to go on their You Look Good tour, which kicks off next week.
What are the ones that people really want to hear from you?
Well, I mean, Need You Now was such a massive song for us.
I'm all alone and I need you now.
Yeah, American Honey, for sure.
Like American Honey.
We're pretty sure they'll be able to add You Look Good to that list pretty soon. Check out all of Lady A's new tunes when Heartbreak comes out June 9th.
This is my whole world. My nurse, my mom, my sickness. I'm 18 and I've never been outside.
Amandla Stenberg is back on the big screen. We first met her as Rue in The Hunger Games. Since then, the teen has been busy making her mark on the internet with sharp commentary on race and culture on social media. Her activism caught the attention of one Beyoncé, leading to a part in Queen Bee's visual album, Lemonade. Now, Stenberg plays the lead in Everything Everything. It's directed by Canadian Stella Meggie and follows Stenberg as a 17-year-old who falls in love with the boy next door, but can't leave her home because she has an immunodeficiency disease. Stenberg says a story like this is exactly the kind she wants to help tell.
The theme of the story is, well, of course, love, but I think it's about breaking out of confines that you or other people may place on you. I hope audiences take away a new perspective, especially when it comes to seeing interracial relationships in film. I hope they're able to see this diversity and accept it, and maybe not even consciously think about it, but have been affected by seeing it.
Everything Everything hits theaters Friday.